We're given a rock in deep space of 10 kilograms. It is being pushed on with a force of, the magnitude of the force is 100 newtons, and is pushing on it at an angle of 30 degrees to the ecliptic plane. So most of the planets, if this is the sun here, most of the planets are in the ecliptic plane, very nearly. Pluto is the only one that has, you know, slight angle, some angle that can be appreciated. Well, not that Pluto's a planet or anything, that whole business. But, okay, so it's a very large distance away from the sun, so that we don't have to consider any of the forces due to the planets or due to the sun itself. So it's up at an angle. Let me try to draw it at 30 degrees. It's being pushed on something like this with a force F, right? Okay, so part A says find the magnitude of the resulting acceleration. So Newton's second law says the sum of the forces, the total net force acting on a particle, is equal to mass times acceleration, right? Well, if what this says is that whatever the direction is of that net force, that is going to be in the same direction as the acceleration. That's why these vectors, that's why it's a vector equation like this, right? So if the force is in this direction, then the particle is going to be accelerated in that direction, right? So all we have to do is find the magnitude of the force, which we're given, it's 100 newtons, and set it equal to 10 times acceleration, because the mass is 10. So we can drop the vectors and say F equals ma, so we only have one force acting. This is 100, this is 10, and then multiplying times the magnitude of the acceleration, dividing by 10, dividing by 10, acceleration is equal to 10 meters per second squared as the magnitude of the acceleration. For part B, it says to find the force as a vector, right? So we're backing up to demonstrate certain ideas. So the force is acting up at an angle of 30 degrees. So to find the force as a vector, its components will be as the following. It will be 100 times the cosine of 30 degrees, x hat, plus 100 times the sine of 30 degrees, y hat. And that's in newtons, right? And the cosine of 30 is 0.866, so this is 86.6 x hat plus 50 y hat, and that's in newtons. So this is the force as a vector. Now let's find the acceleration as a vector. Well, the acceleration is in the same direction, right? The acceleration is like this, so it's also at an angle of 30 degrees to the ecliptic plane. So the acceleration is equal to 10 times the cosine of 30 degrees, x hat, plus 10 times the sine of 30 degrees. And we're running out of room here, so let me find my... write this a little bit smaller. 10 times the cosine of 30 degrees, x hat, plus 10 times the sine of 30 degrees, y hat, and that's in meters per second squared. So then 10 times the cosine of 30 is 8.66, x hat, plus 5 y hat, and that's in meters per second squared. Okay? So Newton's second law says F equals ma, right? Notice that the components are proportional to one another. Notice that F of x is equal to the mass, which is 10 times the acceleration in the x direction. 10 times this equals this. And 10 times this equals this. And in fact, Newton, whenever he first wrote down his second law, he said the following. He said it this way. He said, the acceleration of the object is proportional to the motive force impressed and inversely proportional to the mass of the object. So he said it like this, right? And we see that that's true. We see that this divided by 10 gives this. And it's true for each component. Okay, this is first problem for Newton's second law. I'm going to step out of the way, give you a clear screenshot. Try it for yourself.